everyone, welcome to The Buck Stops Here. I'm Ankita Mukherjee. Our big focus tonight, there's a firestorm over the Rajasthan government's Criminal Laws Amendment Ordinance, which was tabled today. Critics are calling it a gag law that will censor the press and shield corrupt public servants, since it bans the media from disclosing the identity of any public servant facing allegations and makes it mandatory for government sanction to probe all public servants. The executive order has been attacked by two of the BJP's own lawmakers in Rajasthan. But speaking to NDTV today, the Chief Vigilance Commissioner made a case for protecting public servants from fake cases. We're asking tonight, is the Rajasthan government's ordinance unconstitutional? What would be the ramifications if this law were to be extended nationally? What is going to be the political fallout of this for the BJP?
Today, the reason became clear why the Rajasthan government wants what's been criticized as a draconian law that will protect sarpanches and ministers and all government servants from investigation. Without a government nod, nobody will be able to file a court complaint against any public servant. The government has quoted data from the state Home Department to justify its stand. Between 2013 and 17, 2,70,000 court complaints were filed against public officials. These were given to the police to investigate. 73% of these were found to be fake, and the police had to close these cases. The government claims such cases were leading to a paralysis in its functioning and officials were scared to take decisions. But at least two of the ruling party MLAs opposed the move, calling it a bill to protect the corrupt.
हमने आपातकाल इसलिए नहीं लड़ा था कि हम उन किसी का मुंह बंद कर देंगे राज जाने के बाद में तो मैं तो पार्टी के लिए लड़ रहा हूं केवल बेईमानी को बचाने के लिए किया गया है
However, the state and central governments are defending the bill.
ये कानून जो लाया जा रहा है राजस्थान सरकार के द्वारा बिल्कुल परफेक्ट कानून है बैलेंस कानून है
I don't think the law minister of India should comment upon
The ordinance has been challenged in the Rajasthan High Court and will be heard on the 27th of October. Meanwhile, the opposition too staged a protest.
I think the whole country and country is being attacked and we will not give this law to any extent.
The Rajasthan Vidhan Sabha will be in session for 4 days. The controversial ordinance, all set to become a bill, will be discussed in the assembly. But with a brute majority in the Vidhan Sabha, the BJP government looks all set to push this controversial ordinance through till it becomes an act. In Jaipur, with cameraman Shamshu Zoha, Harsha Kumari Singh, NDTV.
All right, joining us on The Buck Stops Here tonight, Soli Sorabji, former Attorney General. We're also being joined by senior journalist Javed Ansari. Joining me here in the studio in Delhi, we will have Shankar Agarwal, former Urban Development Secretary, and Vikramjeet Banerjee, member of the BJP's legal cell and advocate himself. Let's begin tonight with Mr. Sorabji. Thank you for joining us, Soli Sorabji. Then this new rule now gives the government 6 months to decide if a court should order an inquiry into a private complaint against a minister, a lawmaker, or an official. The ordinance now also will restrict the media from even reporting the facts of the matter. I want to ask you, in your opinion, constitutionally speaking, is such an order good in law?
Well, now that the matter has been taken to court, I wouldn't like to pronounce anything on the constitutionality. But my view is that this is a gag order. And it will be very difficult, in my view, for the Rajasthan government to sustain its constitutionality. If reputations of officers are being libeled, take corrective measures. But this is an extreme measure. This is disproportionate. A free press is an important institution in any democracy. And if you gag the press, disclosing the doings, the actions or inactions of a person supposed to be corrupt, then I'm afraid you're really going against the very basis of the philosophy of zero tolerance for corruption. I think the government is gone over the bend, and I wish the Rajasthan government every success, but I think it will be very difficult for her to sustain its validity in a court of law. But what happens in a court of law, of course, is a different matter.
All right. What happens in a court of law is a different matter. But solely, Sir Rabji, eminent jurist, of the opinion that the government has really gone over the bend on this one. Vikramjeet Banerjee, as the lawyer on this panel and also a member of the BJP's legal cell, you know, help us understand the need for such an ordinance and such a law. CRPF Section 197, as the petition that has challenged of the CRPC, has already gives protection to politicians and public servants. So what was the need?
I think there was a note put
for
out.
This amendment.
I'm sure there was a note put out, which you know.
Yes.
The note put out adequately explained the entire question, that there, at the grassroots level, there have been large number of false cases which are being filed and which have just been used to intimidate or harass public servants to work in a certain way. And this was to protect them from such harassment. If you look at the provision itself, the provision says, in the course of performance of its duty. Now, all of us know corruption, etc., which everybody are flagging issues of, are not, you know, the courts have interpreted that it will never fall within the course of their duty. So the protection here, which is given in these provisions, are only extremely limited provisions. This is only limited to any job done in course of their duty. Mm-hmm. So, in the present case, I think, of course, that it is, it takes into account, it tries to strike a balance between, on one side, you know, leaving out other questions whereby, you know, corruption issues, which obviously fall outside and therefore, which has rightly to be investigated, and things which are inside, which is in anything done in the performance of one's duty, which needs to be protected. So I think in more or less, it's a balanced, a very balanced ordinance.
All right. The BJP insisting that this is a balanced ordinance. Javed Ansari, I want to bring you in on this point that is being raised in this note. You know, we heard the defense of the Rajasthan government today, which said that between 2013 and 2017, as many as 2,70,000 complaints were filed against public officials. These were given to the police to investigate. 73% of these were found to be fake. The police had to close these cases, and this was unnecessary harassment for these officials, and that's the reason why this amendment is necessary.
So if you carry forward this logic, then a lot of investigations that are carried out or complaints that are made, criminal complaints against people, that should also be, that should, an end should be put to that forthwith, because more than 70% of them are either found bogus or the people against whom complaints are made are found to be innocent. I think this is by far the most serious attempt, legislative attempt, to gag the media. The only thing that I can recall that comes close to this is the defamation bill that the Rajiv Gandhi government had sought to bring, but had to be to a hasty retreat on. The BJP would be well advised to withdraw this, or else this perception will gain ground that the BJP is trying to grab, stroke, strong arm the media.
All right. We'll come to the media question in a moment from now, because really that needs a separate discussion on its own merits. But Shankar Agarwal, to come back to the question of this government defense, that there were 73% fake cases, cases designed to harass public officials. Is there a case to be made, in your opinion, that merits such an ordinance being brought in?
You see, there is no doubt that large number of people are making frivolous complaints, and they make false complaints against the officer whom they find little difficult. And when they do not get the work done as per their own wishes, they make all kinds of complaints against the officer concerned. And what has been done? It is not being said that these cases will not be investigated. These cases can be investigated provided the government comes to a conclusion, yes, there is some kind of a substance. And that is nothing wrong in that. Otherwise, there will be large number of frivolous complaints. And if you start investigating each and every frivolous complaint, then it will be like a character assassination without going into the detail.
Mr. Agarwal, there have been so many instances in the past where, where politicians couldn't even have been named if such a law had been enforced nationally. I mean, we can talk about the 2G scam, the CWG scam, many such instances where, for instance, the BJP have really gone to town, even when those charges or allegations weren't proved against the specific public officers or politicians involved. How is this law in public interest when you are gagging the media from even reporting on such allegations?
No, ma'am, but what happens because once the case has been investigated by the government and government comes to a conclusion, yes, there is substance, naturally it will be investigated by the investigating agency thereafter. But why are we doubting the intention of the government at the first instance? I, as Director of Vigilance in Government of India, whenever we used to, and I used to get complaints against all IS officers of the country, and what we used to do, first we used to make some kind of a discreet inquiry whether this particular complaint has got some substance or not. And once we used to come to a conclusion, yes, this complaint has got some substance, and thereafter we used to take the version of the officer concerned, and we used to find out from the ministry or the department or the state government concerned, and thereafter we used to initiate the pre-disciplinary proceedings. Otherwise, today what is happening, that if I am unable to get something work done through some officer or through some judge or somebody, I will start making all kinds of complaints.
Okay.